Hi, I'm Dave Balkan. I'm the owner of Joseph L. Balkan, Inc. We're New York City's largest house sewer and water service line contractor. And I'd like to just take a minute or two to explain to you about a ball valve. These valves became legal as the main control valve in the early 1990s in New York City. There's a couple of things you should know. These valves are rated higher than a gate valve. They're more dependable than a gate valve, but they have to be full port opening in order to be legal. What that means is the ball inside this valve has to be equal to the pipe size that it's servicing. It can't be restricted in any way. These valves are very simple to operate, but again, people run into problem handling valves because they think brute force might be the answer, which it never is. You should exercise a valve once a year. If you don't, the handle may become frozen in place. That doesn't mean jerk it or hit it with anything. What that means is you can take a piece of pipe, like so, extend it over the handle, you now have leverage, and you just gently, gently move the valve. Now, another thing that you should know about these valves are these are quick opening valves. You always have to handle them gently, meaning if you have turned the water off in your house and the water has drained out, there's now air in your lines. If you quickly open up the water, the new water will come shooting through the pipe, and as soon as it hits a bend, an elbow, it's water hammer. It can break apart your plumbing. So anytime a valve is closed, you open a sink, you gently turn the valve on until there's a flow of water, and you are 100% positive there's no more air in the line. Then you can open it fully. And that's a little bit about ball valves. I hope that helps you. Thank you.